Hello everyone, it's an immense pleasure for me to present this poster in front of you at the Peer Review Congress. I'm Dr. Sunanda Das from New Delhi, India, the editorial head at the Journal of Clinical and Diagnostic Research. My co-authors are Dr. Aarti Garg, she's a deputy chief editor, and Dr. Heman Jain, who's a chief editor at the journal. The aim of the journal, of the study, which is basically a cross-sectional retrospective study, was to quantify the manuscripts that were withdrawn or abandoned after receiving the peer review report. This is an important aspect of the study. And especially for the withdrawn manuscripts, we sought to find the reasons for the withdrawals. Now, this was basically an endeavor to look into the editorial resource losses that occur. And it was a special study because it is more relevant for the standalone journals that do not have this APC model. They do not charge article processing fees. So such abandonments and withdrawals are a harder impact for such journals. Hence, the study was relevant for us. And the working definitions are: abandoned manuscripts were those in which the authors did not write to us for more than 4 months after the last correspondence. And withdrawn manuscripts were those where there was an email from the author requesting a withdrawal of their manuscript. Now, the withdrawal and abandoned submissions within this 4 years were considered, January 2018 to December 2021. Now, these are the outcome variables. And especially for the withdrawn manuscripts, we also analyze the gap between the submission of the manuscript and the withdrawal and the reasons for the withdrawal as stated in the email. So, coming to the special findings of the study, we found that within these 4 years, there were 1,075 withdrawn and abandoned manuscripts, 925 abandoned, and 150 emails where the authors asked for withdrawal. So it was a cumulative 1,075 submissions, and we found that it was 7 to 13% of each year's submissions that were abandoned, and 1 to 3% of submissions that were withdrawn. So that's quite a good number, unfortunately. And an important aspect to highlight here is that it actually reflects the practices in academia that quite a good number of such withdrawals and abandonments have senior academicians among them, professors among them. And as regards to the country of origin, we found that there was no special bearing on the author behavior in relation to the country of origin. Now, the first feedback was actually decently timed, and it was sent within 1.5 months, which is in line with our journal policy. But the withdrawal emails were written within a variable period of 1 month to 3 months. Now, coming to the reasons for withdrawal for the 150 submissions, the majority of the emails, comprising of 43%, that is one third, of the emails did not actually write any reason to us. The authors just wanted a withdrawal, blank. And the next is about 23% of the submissions in which the authors, they were not willing to revise. And 17% had other reasons, like they had their own conformities. They did not want to follow the journal guidelines. So what did we learn from the study? Probably that the presence of a senior academician do not guarantee good practice. And despite sending such timely feedbacks, authors do not respond back. And when we quantified the amount of editorial work loss, we found it a good 3 months of editorial work loss within 1 year. And the country of origin had no relation to how the author behaves. Majority of the emails do not mention the reason for withdrawal. They just want their articles to be withdrawn. And in fact, we found 17 such submissions which reached the stage of publication. That is, all the work was done. But we got to stall it because at the penultimate stage, it was abandoned or withdrawn. So all of it, all the work is gone to drain. So what are the takeaways? Indeed, it's a big resource loss for such journals. And an unanswered question, how and whom to approach a journal, because a journal has nowhere to go when the institutional heads or senior academicians are themselves involved in such misconducts. And probably such repeat defaulters are submissions from the same departments, so they deserve blacklisting. And the policy that is under discussion at JCDR after this study is that we may even charge a fraction of the publication charges right at the time of submissions. And future aspect, maybe we can color code the authors depending upon their past behavior, considering the factors like the quality of submissions, the review report suggestions, how much they are compliant, or if they have a timely correspondence. Now, that is what we plan to study for the future. That's all. If you have any further questions or want to know more about the study and what did we find, please do write to us. We'll get back to you as soon as we can. Thank you. Thank you so much for the opportunity.